Good afternoon to one and all present here. Myself, Dr. Tamanna Swapnaharika. I'm a dental student under the University Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences. I would like to start off my presentation on identifying drugs using dental heart tissue in forensic science. I'd like to state a quote. It is not the drugs that make a drug addict. It's the need to escape reality. It's a quote all of us should really brainstorm about. Now, as we know, the abuse of recreational drugs has become a problem of growing interest in many countries in the world, hence increasing the demand for evaluation of drug abuse, mostly for court trials and post-mortem toxicology. Forensic toxicology, what is it? It is a broad science that integrates principles and practices about toxicology and legal aspects which occur in conjunction with medico-legal instances, as with homicide, suicide, road traffic, and other types of accident and disasters. One might wonder, why would dental heart tissues or teeth have to be used as a source to assess or identify drug usage? And the reason is that in cases where conventional samples that are analyzed to assess drug use, such as uncontaminated hair, blood, nails, and urine are not available, the next best sample would to obtain for this would be teeth. So I'd like to define what dentin is because it's a prerequisite understanding necessary to go ahead with this. So dentin is a hard dental tissue that in vital teeth is in contact with the blood, which irrigates the dental pulp, and therefore the chemicals present in the blood can reach the dentin. It is also a tissue with a slow metabolic turnover, meaning that the incorporation of these chemicals takes place at a slow rate. Due to the extraordinary hardness of dental tissues, it may be protected from environmental degradation, chemical changes, decomposition, and changes due to heat, making it an invaluable source of data from toxicological point of view. The part of the teeth that can be assessed to check for drugs are the carious material or caries if present, the dentinal part of the crown, the dentinal part of the root, and cementum. A few situations where dental tissue and forensic toxicology would prove to be useful are as follows. As an alternate biological matrix in investigation of previous chronic exposure to chemicals, if the cause of death is indicated to be due to drug abuse and gaining the person's drug intake information is required when there is limited sample available. Or if we are studying unidentified, putrefied, or skeletonized human remains, it may be difficult to obtain information on drug habits, which may prove important for the construction of a biological profile in the context of a reconstructive identification process. So let's understand the routes of drug deposition. The routes are either through the oral cavity or through blood. So if the drug deposition happens via the oral cavity, it occurs through the saliva, which then gets deposited into the enamel and then the dentin. If it is via blood, the bloodstream is also connected to the tooth via the pulp. So the chemical deposition occurs to the pulp and then to the dentin. The following are the drugs that can be analyzed from teeth. These are nicotine, cotinine, cannabis products, morphine, heroin, codeine, opiates, amphetamines, and benzodiazepines. And some of the internal standards used for these drugs in the experiment have been mentioned. For opiates, it's nalorphine. For cocaine, it's proadifin. Nicotine, NENN or 1N-ethylnornicotine. And for cotinine, it is NENC or ethylnornicotine. And the methods used to analyze drugs in the teeth are gas chromatography and liquid chromatography followed by mass spectrometry. And from the tables you can see here, there have been major findings in various studies. In table one, it shows the drugs of abuse whose concentration has been analyzed by a gas chromatography or mass spectrometry method and their mean value concentrations. The most prevalent drug was COC, which is an indicator for cocaine, followed by tetrahydrocannabinol, which was present in the samples of teeth collected from chronic drug abusers. In another study, 6-MAM, which is the unequivocal marker for heroin abuse, was the analyte most frequently found in samples from heroin consumers. Here, the data was not correlated with the years of drug consumption or with the data of the quitting habit. So it might not be possible to correlate pattern of drug habit. The concentrations of opiates in teeth were higher than those encountered for cocaine and their metabolites. It seems that the amount of substance found in teeth related to a consumption of a certain drug depends on the chemical nature of parent drug and metabolites, which migrate from blood vessels to the tooth pulp and then to the dentin and enamel. Coming to the next slide, we have a table below assessment of benzodiazepines. So this shows the different benzodiazepine drugs, and next to that you can see a column which shows the treatment period. So the samples were obtained from patients who had undergone the treatment for the following years, and as you can see, alprazolam was the drug which was identified in most of the cases, almost 7 out of these 16 cases. And in 4 cases, you will observe that, that is 15, 16, 6, and 7, that even though they have undergone treatment for these years, there was no detection of the drug. This is one of the shortcomings of the study, which shows that a prerequirement for detecting the drugs from these teeth would be that the teeth has to be vital. By that I mean the pulp has to be alive or living. So maybe during the treatment, the vitality of the teeth was non-vital. And below the heading analytes in different samples, you will find that the corresponding analytes were they were detected in various samples. And in the last three, you will see that they have been compared in the tooth root, crown, and carious material. And it has been seen that most of the drugs have been detected in the carious material, and then the crown root, and then the crown, and then the tooth root, and then the tooth crown. So by this, we can conclude that teeth are actually a useful alternative in postmortem toxicology. And our prerequirement to detect the drugs would be that it has to be vital at the time of drug consumption. And they are a promising non-invasive biological matrix in biomedical analysis for both clinical and forensic purposes. Thank you.